Are there certain parts of the neocortex or other areas of the brain more affected than others?
Okay, what's neocortex?
The big two lobes up here on top.
All right. Okay.
So give me a minute because I don't have a brain here, so you'll just see me disappearing for a second.
Okay. We're going to get a brain.
Okay. Aren't you glad I asked?
And now we have the brain.
Wow.
Okay, we have a brain now.
Okay, here we go. The neocortex. Now
so
I know.
So you see on the purple here.
Pull it back. Pull the brain back a little. There you go. Okay. Now we got it. Okay, good.
So the surface of the brain is what Dr. Harness referred to, which is the neocortex. Mm-hmm. And the part that we know it's affected by chemotherapy for this part of the brain are the frontal lobes.
Oh.
Which are the first part of the brain, the ones that are above our nose. And this is where your executive function is, planning your job, planning a party, planning a trip. But the part that we're also very interested on, and a deep, deep, deep structure on our brain is the hippocampus.
Oh, okay.
And the hippocampus is the place where our memories are formed and stored. That's why we have found that that's very important in Alzheimer's disease, in other memory type of diseases. And it's a part that it's so important that, by example, when we consider patients for radiation therapy to the brain, we always try not to give radiation, if possible, to that part of the brain. Mm-hmm. It's a small structure. It looks like a seahorse. That's what hippocampus means. Mm-hmm. But it's an essential control center for our brain. And our research in the lab shows that that's the site of the most damage.
Mm. When a person does receive chemotherapy and they get the chemo brain, when you mentioned Alzheimer's or even a dementia, does that increase their chances to get early onset of dementia or Alzheimer's because of this?
What we have found out, Lisa, is that not necessarily that Alzheimer's dementia will be related to chemotherapy. Indeed, it is not.
Okay.
But that about 11% of the patients that got chemotherapy are surviving their cancers. Now we're talking 10 to 20 years in the future, have more memory problems and are getting to the level of being diagnosed with a memory disorder.
Okay.
We share many features with the most common ones as Alzheimer or multivascular dementia. And it's not that necessary there will be the same entity, the same problem, but they do affect the same structures of the brain as I was showing you before, the deep structure of the brain named hippocampus.
Okay. Wow, that was interesting. See, you ask a question and look what pops up, Dr. Harness, a brain.
A brain, I love it. What good neurologist what good neurologist I know doesn't have a brain laying around somewhere?
I know.
So exactly, handy. That. You always need an extra one.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.